ISUPK.
To the family, brother Red Pill representing No The Ledge. Do me a favor, family, make sure you subscribe to ISUPK on YouTube. Get some of that fire that the brothers are delivering, some of that good information, all right? Brah.
The white man, he pushes all these holidays on black people. How many of you know the history of where Mother's Day came from? Because it ain't from the Bible. Go ask a pastor to open the Bible and show you where Mother's Day is. It ain't in the Bible. You understand? Ask a pastor to go show you where Valentine's Day is, where Christmas is in the Bible. He can't show you these things. Because it's not in the Bible. The pastor has been working against black people here, man. Hispanics and Native Indian. He's been working for the white man, who we call the devil the Bible speaks of. You understand? Just said a white man deceived us. Your pastor is going into the church tomorrow to deceive our black woman, our black man, into taking Mother's Day as a holy day sent by God. And that's a lie. I mean, you know where Mother's Day came from? It goes all the way back to Egypt, to Isis. You understand? Then it came to the Greek gods. I believe it's Sibyl. They call her in Greek. You understand? And it came all the way into the Christian church. Now you're celebrating Mother's Day. Now you're worshiping Mary. You understand? Now the Catholics say what? Prayers to Mary. You understand? And say, no, they don't worship Mary. You are worshiping that woman in the church. Whatever religion you in, you are going to worship a woman. That's why Ashley, what's her name? Ashley what? Aisha Curry. You know what I mean? That's why she would get up and say that foul thing. Because the Christian church don't teach you the Bible, man.
That's right.
Give me Exodus. Start me off at Exodus 24 and 14. You understand?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're a Caucasian person, man. You think we lying? You come up here and say something, man. You come up here and prove what the ISUPK has been saying about white people is a lie. You know what I mean? Don't just smile and stand back and think, you know, whatever. Come and say something, man. Say something. Read verse 14.
Exodus chapter 24, verse 14. And he said unto the elders,
34 verse 14. Exodus 34 verse 14. We're going to get it, man. You understand? We ain't supposed to be worshiping no woman according to this Bible. We ain't supposed to be doing it. The Christian church pushed this white statue of so-called Mary. Let me see that statue of Mary. Let me see that statue of Mary. You understand? That's why we got a rope around this whore's neck. You understand? This is who Ashley, I pronounce this, Aisha Cole is following after. This right here, this white woman, this ain't the mother of God. This is some whore of some white man. That ain't mother of God. That ain't mother of Christ. Christ's mother was a black woman.
That's right.
To be specific, she was a Levite. You understand? Not no Caucasian female. Ain't nothing good came from between a white woman's leg.
That's right.
You understand?
Yeah.
Everything that came from between a leg had to be injected with like you, black man. Just to be like you. To make all the rules in the sports to suit the white man. You understand? He became the quarterback that made rules to protect him. You understand? Because those brothers was crushing him. Right. He can't stand to those hit. Those brothers be putting down on him.
That's right.
So they don't even know what to do? To go throw up the rules. You understand? For the white boys. You understand? Come on. Where we at? Exodus 34 and 14, right? All right, let's go.
Exodus chapter 34, verse 14. For thou shalt worship no other god.
This is one of your commandments by God. What does God say?
For thou shalt worship no other god.
What is Mother's Day? Mother's Day is a worship of a white woman. That's what it is. It started back in Egypt, and then it came all to the Greeks, to the Romans, then to here, America, now Mary.
Right.
You understand? You understand? How the hell are we going to celebrate Mother's Day when our black sisters are killing babies?
Right.
How are we going to celebrate Mother's Day? Is that a day for us to look forward to? We should try to get these sisters out these abortion clinics. That's what we should do.
Right.
You understand? As black men, Hispanic men, and Native Indian men.
Yeah.
I thought the children was our future.
Right.
You understand? But you want to celebrate Mother's Day? To hell with Mother's Day, man. As we begin, we're going to clean our sisters up and have them right. Not looking forward to Mother's Day, but being a mother every day in her life. You understand? Being a wife every day in her life. And not trying to be a whore like Miss Curry, like Aisha Curry, wanting other men to look at her. What kind of a whore statement is that? A black man going to put his life on the line playing basketball could blow his knee out any day. Bringing all that money into the house and you want another man to look at you? You understand? Go look in the strip club as Captain Meshach say, man. Go in that strip club if you want another man to look at you. You understand? You're going to get all the attention you want. You understand? Now I see what they're learning in the Christian churches. That's what they're teaching our sisters in the Christian church. My man, if he could go get more woman, then I could go get more man. That's what they're teaching in the Christian church, right? 50-50. You understand? You see how wrong that is? The Bible teach you to have a woman, you're going to have to put a hedge around her. You're going to have to put rules on that woman, or she's going to be running out in the street. Like Miss Curry, talking a pack of rubbish. You understand? Making Stephen Curry look like a fool. You know how he's feeling in the locker room with his boys right now? When his wife just made a whore statement. You understand? They were looking like if they were a power couple as the word was out on the street. But the only power couples you're gonna get is in the UPK. Ain't no other place you're gonna get no power couple. The Christian church has a reputation of having whores and divorces. You understand? You come into the ICPA, you're gonna learn. Black woman, you're gonna learn how to shut your mouth and serve your man. And black man, you're gonna learn how to be a ruler over that house righteously. You understand? That's what you're gonna learn. You're gonna learn this. Because this is one commandment that God said. Read.
For the Lord, whose name is jealous, is a jealous God.
You understand? God is jealous when you go celebrate Mother's Day. You go celebrate Mother's Day. You go give that monster, that abortionist, something on Mother's Day. You worship that woman on Mother's Day. God is a jealous God. And when God is jealous, you don't want to be around when God is jealous. God puts people to death. God killed a whole nation. You understand? Almost wiped out a whole African nation, those Egyptians. You don't want to play with God when he's jealous, man. You understand? Read.
For thou, sluggy. Lest thou make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land.
Lest thou what?
Make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land.
Now your black preachers have made a covenant with a white man by celebrating Mother's Day. By celebrating Christmas, all these holidays that is not in the Bible, and God told us not to celebrate. You wait around here, I'm gonna show you in the Bible where God ain't for your holidays. You wait around long enough, I'm gonna show you more things your pastor showed you in your whole entire life. You understand? I don't care what church you went to. You could have gone to Joel Osteen Church. I'm going to show you more things than Joel Osteen today. You understand? You could have gone to Creflo Dollar T.D. Jakes Church. I'm going to show you more things in this Bible today. Because I've been taught by men of God, by the prophets of God in this Bible. You understand? That's who I've been taught by. That's who I've been educated on when it comes to this Bible. You understand? So I know right from wrong. And I know it's wrong to celebrate Mother's Day. You understand? And it's wrong for a pastor who's supposed to be a shepherd in his community to go teach black people, Hispanics, and Native Indians to celebrate Mother's Day. You understand? The white man, he could celebrate Mother's Day. The Chinese, he can go celebrate Mother's Day. You understand? All these other nations, they can go celebrate Mother's Day, and God won't be jealous. And I can show you in the Bible. How where you at? Give me Psalms 147 and 19. How where you at? Right? Don't lose Exodus 34. We're going to go back to it. You understand? But go to Psalms 147 and 19. I'm going to show you how God deals with blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, man. We cannot afford to do what white people are doing. You see how white people are living? White people are mass murderers. White people are serial killers. You understand? White people are terrorists. You understand? And yet still they're in charge of the whole entire earth. That's because they are not God's chosen people. You understand? The white man was put in that position because black people, we failed to obey God. And I'm going to show you that in the Bible here as soon as a brother get it in Psalms 147 and 19. You understand what I'm saying? Because we, as black people, we need to be righteous. More righteous than the white man. He can be the devil and survive and run a Fortune 500 company successfully. You understand? He can snort cocaine, wake up in the morning, go to work as normal. Black men, you snort cocaine, you do drugs, we get bummed out the mind, man. You understand? Read.
Psalms 147, chapter 147, verse 19. He showeth his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel.
Hold on. I thought God sent Christ to die for everybody. I thought God loves everybody. But God is singling out somebody here, man. What is God saying here?
He showeth his word unto Jacob.
He showeth his word unto who?
Jacob.
He showeth his word unto Jacob. And the words are these laws and statutes and judgments in this Bible. Paul wrote to blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Matthew, Mark, John, Luke, all of them wrote to black brothers, Hispanics and Native Indians. Ezekiel, Jeremiah, Isaiah, all of these men wrote to blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. And this is proof right here. Read it one more time.
He showed his word unto Jacob, this his statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He have not dealt so with any nation.
Hold on. He has what?
He have not dealt so with any nation.
So what are they teaching us in the Christian church, man? The Christian church said what? That Christ died for everybody. That God loves everybody. But that's not what's in the Bible. I'm reading out the King James Bible. The same one the preacher has on the pulpit that he doesn't read out of. You recognizing that? Your preacher, your Christian pastor is not reading out the Bible.
That's right.
Read it again. I don't think they hear us clearly, man. I don't think they hear what God had to say here clearly. Read.
He showed his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He have not dealt so with any nation.
He has not dealt so with what?
Any nation.
He has not dealt so with a white man.
Any nation.
He has not dealt so with a Chinese.
Any nation.
He has not dealt so with an African.
Any nation.
He has not dealt so with a Japanese.
Any nation.
He has not dealt so with the Arabs.
Any nation.
God ain't deal with us like he dealt with those other nations. He gave black people the laws, statutes, and commandments. That's what we read it in Exodus. Go to back to Exodus now and read it from the top. To let black people, Hispanics, and Native Indian know that to celebrate Mother's Day is an evil and wicked holiday. Evil and a wicked holiday. Why the hell we don't celebrate Mother's Day every day? You understand? Read.
Exodus chapter 34, verse 14. For thou shalt worship no other God, for the Lord whose name is jealous is a jealous God. Lest thou make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land.
Lest you make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land. We made an agreement when we walked into those Christian church with a white man and started worshiping Cesare Borgia. You understand? Start worshiping that white picture of that white statue of Mary. That's a covenant we made with a so-called white man. But it's a sin against God. God is against it. Read.
And they go a horn after their gods and do sacrifice unto their
gods. Hold on. What does God say? I'm going what?
A horn after their gods.
And go whoring after a god. After their God. I can't get her name right, so I'm going to call her Miss Curry. She is whoring after the white man's God. That's what she is doing. And God said it in the Bible right here. When you go make a covenant with the Christian church, with the Muslim mosques, with all these other nations, you whore after their God. You understand? You become whores. You become vile. You become disgusting in the sight of God when you go become a Christian.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, so packed, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good ship. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom the breath of life, I don't believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword. With